My name is Michael Isom, and I'm a program manager with digital experience in the Lehi, Utah office. After more than 25 years in government, corporate settings, and the last three here at Adobe, I often feel like I still don't belong. You see, sometimes I still see myself as a misfit in middle or high school. Long hair, earring, an interesting attempt at a mustache, and angry at the world. What you can't see from that picture is that I was on a slippery slope to nowhere. In fact, by the time I graduated from high school, I had five stepdads, had been in multiple alternative schools for delinquent students, had moved 13 times, and was poor and even sometimes homeless. In fact, occasionally we didn't even have Thanksgivings or Christmases, but for the kindness of others when a bag or a box would show up on our doorstep. Wherever we seemed to go, drugs, crime, and violence were there, and being the new kid certainly didn't help. When my mom remarried and we moved to a single-wide trailer in rural Georgia, I thought it would be nice to have a fresh start. But my hopes were unfounded, as I really couldn't leave my troubled past behind, kept getting suspended and attracting the wrong kind of attention. I also remember the day when Principal Smith pulled me aside in the hallway, put his hand on my shoulder, and said something that profoundly impacted me. "Look around you," he said. "A third of your classmates are going to be in prison. A third are going to be on welfare, and a third might make something of themselves. Which third do you want to be?" His words struck me to the core as I had seen firsthand how a few bad choices had put family members and friends on very unfortunate paths. Perhaps for the first time, I could clearly see where I was headed, and it scared me. It was also humbling because I knew the principal was exactly right. I was at a decision point. Change my direction or continue a predictable spiral downward. Although there was a two-year community college nearby, I simply didn't have a way to pay for it. And although I don't remember exactly when, someone suggested the military as an option. The more I explored the idea, the more it appealed to me, since if I joined, I knew I'd no longer have to worry about where I would sleep, where the next meal would come from, whether I'd have insurance or not, and how to pay for education. These were the biggest concerns I had at the time, and if this security was all I had gotten, it would have been worth it. But I got so much more. For me, the military opened a world I couldn't even envision at the time. It wasn't easy, and it still isn't, but it has always been worth it. Like everyone else, my journey into the military began at basic training, which is a lot like what you see in the movies. Essentially, the goal is to break you down and then rebuild you as a soldier. For me, that meant shedding the selfishness and the apathy and the bias of my past and replacing it with the military principles of loyalty, duty, respect, service, honor, integrity, and courage. The military literally saved my life, and what's more, it launched me into a bigger and even more beautiful world. Through the military, I learned to speak Chinese and some Arabic. I earned a law degree. I advised government leaders on critical Asian and Middle Eastern affairs. And yes, I've been to war. As former General Dwight Eisenhower said, "I hate war as only a soldier can." I've lost friends to war. And I still cringe at the sound of fireworks as they bring me back to enemy attacks. But I've also been able to protect innocent villages, fight against oppression, and help rebuild schools, bridges, and hospitals, making any sacrifice I could make worth it. For me, the military did more than build character or offer a career. It truly opened my eyes. When I first arrived in Afghanistan, I ignorantly labeled the people there in three ways: Taliban, Al-Qaeda, or not quite sure yet. Soon, my eyes began to open to the strong family bonds and the rich traditions of a people that have been through hell with centuries of invasions and war. Next, my personal faith was strengthened While I was in the Middle East observing the practice of a faith cherished by nearly 2 billion people. In mosques, I saw the wealthy stand shoulder to shoulder with the poor, with the understanding that all are equal before God. What I learned from these and other experiences was that we miss all that makes us the same when we only focus on what makes us different. More recently, I was humbled to protect protesters as they challenged injustices and systemic inequality. This isn't always what you hear the military is about, but I can tell you I will always be proud to have played a small role in guaranteeing these and other rights for my friends and my fellow citizens. All of my experiences helped me to see that at the end of the day, we have more in common than we realize. Sure, we have differences, but as we take a step back, we realize we also value so many of the same things. I think Principal Smith was right. Odds are prison or poverty were in my future. The military, however, was a lifeline, and perhaps the only one I was going to get. While some might argue I'm still a misfit, I am now a misfit that has seen and treasured so much of the world by setting aside my personal fears and bias, becoming uncomfortable, and stepping forward to serve others, becoming, I believe, a better person along the way. Everyone has a story, and you probably wouldn't have guessed mine. That boy in Georgia was trapped by the things around him. But in large part due to the military, the man I am today has listened and heard so much more. The more each of us are willing to share our stories, the stronger we become as individuals, communities, and as a company. I sincerely hope you will share your story, and I thank you for listening to mine.